Thomas worried that Sir Hat would be upset with him about his incident with the coaches. But because Sir Hat had been so busy, he hadn't had time to come to see any of the engines at all. With the fear of reprimand still in his thoughts, Thomas tried to keep himself to himself as much as possible. Unfortunately, Gordon had begun teasing him. "Fancy leaving your coaches behind," he remarked one day as he left to take another express. "Poor little Thomas, I wonder if you'll ever be able to pull trains again. Perhaps you should stick to station piloting." He chortled as he left the sheds. Edward tried to cheer Thomas up. "Don't worry, Thomas," he said encouragingly. "Sir Hat knows that you're trying very hard to be productive." "Does he though?" said Thomas. "He hasn't come to talk to me about the incident, nor my driver and fireman." "Perhaps that's a good thing then," said Edward. "There are more important things going on with Sir Hat at present, like finding other engines to come and help us. I would personally chalk it down to a life experience for you. If Sir Hat isn't worried about it, then neither should you be." Pondered Thomas. "Perhaps you're right, Edward. But I would love to go exploring again. It was nice to see the other side of the island with Gordon and the Normanby branch line. It's nice and all though, but there's so much more to see, so much more to do."
"Tell you what," said Edward quietly. "I have a freight train to take to Wellsworth tomorrow. Perhaps, if we can arrange it, I could do the station piloting here, and you could take my trucks for me. How does that sound?"
"Are you sure, Edward?" asked Thomas.
"Absolutely," said Edward. "As long as our crews agree to it, of course."
So, the next morning, the two engines spoke to their drivers, who in turn spoke to Sir Hat on the telephone. Thomas was nervous when his driver returned. Had Sir Hat said anything to him about their little mishap with the coaches? But his driver looked rather pleased as he spoke to the other crew members. "Charles has said that he's happy for the change to go ahead," smiled the driver.
"Did he say anything about..."
began Thomas, but his driver interrupted.
"No, he didn't. He seemed in very good spirits, actually. I don't think we should worry about it too much, Thomas."
Thomas finally smiled.
"Perhaps I'm in the clear after all then," he puffed. "Well, that's all arranged then. Shall we go and find our train then?"
he asked the driver.
"I suppose we'd better," came the reply.
"Come on then." As Thomas puffed away, he spoke again.
"And for goodness sake, make sure I'm actually coupled up this time, please."
Edward smiled to himself as his own driver spoke.
"This is a nice thing you've done for Thomas, Edward."
"He deserves it," said Edward. "I can see the potential he has, and he's been a very good friend. It's the least I could do."
Thomas soon found the trucks. They looked surprised as the tank engine approached.
"You're not Edward," they said.
"I'm Thomas," he said. "And I'm taking you down the line instead of Edward today."
The trucks grumbled as Thomas buffered up, slightly harder than he intended.
"Ouch!" screeched the trucks as they were coupled up.
Thomas ignored them, as he was too excited to be pulling another train again. As he puffed out of the yard, the trucks continued to chatter among themselves as they headed off down the line. Thomas wasn't used to trucks, nor long journeys, and unfortunately for him, he kept accidentally bumping them as he fumbled along the line, nervous about signals and points, hoping he wouldn't go the wrong way or overrun a signal. The trucks complained, but again, Thomas ignored them, still preoccupied with trying to remember where he was and where the tricky inclines were. As they slowed down and bumped into each other again, the trucks decided to try and get even when they next got a chance. The truck's chance soon came, as Thomas passed through Marin. Neither Thomas nor his crew had realised that they were approaching the very top of Gordon's Hill. Usually, on a train like this one, they would stop at Marin to apply the brakes on the trucks, but Thomas and his crew forgot to do so. Their chance had come. As Thomas passed through the cutting and onto the downhill slope, the trucks surged into each other and forward into Thomas. This caught him off guard, and he shouted, "What's happening? Stop! Stop!" "You bumped us, so we'll bump you," laughed the trucks, as they began to accelerate down Gordon's Hill. Thomas tried his hardest to push back against the trucks, but it was no good. They raced down the hill at high speed, until finally, Thomas felt the gradient level out. Realising how close they were to Wellsworth, Thomas's crew put his brakes on as hard as they could, and they finally began to slow down. Then, Thomas saw something that horrified him as they approached the station. "The points!" he shouted. "We're going into the sidings!" His driver took desperate action. He put Thomas into reverse gear and opened up the regulator, hoping to push back against the trucks and slow them down faster. It seemed to be working, for as they crossed the points into the yard, they began to slow down significantly. Finally, with help from the handbrakes of the guard's van, they came to a stop, just a few inches from the buffers at the end of the siding. Thomas gasped as he looked ahead of him. "Phew! We stopped!" he said triumphantly. But this didn't last for long, for Thomas now saw a figure approaching him. It was Charles Hatt, and Thomas gulped as he approached. "Hello, Thomas. That was a close call, was it not?"
It was, sir. I'm sorry, sir. I was pushed by the trucks. I tried to stop, but..."
"Sounds to me like you need to learn a little more about dealing with trucks and pulling trains," said Charles thoughtfully. "Especially after what happened with that branch train to Normanby."
"Sir," said Thomas weakly.
"It's all right, Thomas. It happens," smiled Charles. "All is forgiven, nobody was hurt, and nobody complained. Now, about your current situation..." Thomas gulped again. "I've been trying to arrange several things over the last few weeks, and I've come to an arrangement with the LMS."
Really? About what, sir?"
"About station piloting duties at Vicarstown," said Charles. "The LMS has agreed to supply their own pilot engine for the time being."
"Meaning?" "Meaning that I can do some other work, sir."
"Precisely," smiled Charles. "With the situation at Vicarstown in order, I think that you should stay here for a little while and learn a bit more about trucks. Edward can help you. He knows more about trucks than any other engine I know."
"Oh, that would be wonderful, sir. Thank you," said Thomas.
"Not a problem, Thomas. Now, I have to catch the next train back to Tidmouth shortly, so if you'd like to shunt these trucks away..."
"Yes, sir,"
said Thomas, as Charles headed back towards the station. As he slowly backed the trucks out of the siding, he reflected upon how lucky he was, not only to have avoided a nasty accident, but to have finally been given an opportunity to do something different. Hoping that he wouldn't mess up again, Thomas slowly went off to shunt the trucks.